Hello friends, in this video we'll see basics commands in R language. So in today's session we'll discuss basic commands in R like getwd to get current working directory, setwd which set current working directory, then assign, how to assign values to the variables, to display values of variables, how to paste the values, how to concatenate the values, to display data types of object, sprintf function, substring function in R, how to use how to substitute words in existing string in R language. Now we'll see demonstration of this command one by one. So first command we'll see get wd to get working directory. So to execute this command we can use short key by pressing Ctrl and Enter. This is console. In the console it shows the output of current command which we executed. Now if we want to set current working directory to particular directory, we can use the command setwd. So initially our working directory is C colon users and documents. With this command, if we want to set our R program as current working directory, we can type the command like setwd in the bracket double quotes and path of R program which is on the desktop. So with this our current after executing this setwd our current working directory path is set to R program. To check whether it is set or not, we can execute the command getwd after that. See here. Now our current working directory is R program. To assign the values, next command we'll see to how to assign the values to the variables. There are two ways to assign the values to the variable. So we consider variable x, angle bracket, dash, and 10. This is one way in which we can assign value to the variable. So x, this 10 gets assigned to x. We can use equal to sign to assign the values. So with this it is get assigned to 15 get assigned to x. Then if we want to assign 20 to the x, we can assign it in the same way. So we can use this sign also, equal to sign also, or this sign also to assign the value to the variable. If we want to print or display the value of variable x, we can only write x. It will show us the current value. So 20 is the latest value which we assign to x. After that, if we want to print the value of variable, we can use the command, print of x. So it shows 20. Now if we want to display the value of variable, we can use the paste command. So after executing paste command, we will get output like the value is x. So value is 20. Then if we want to execute the cat command, it gets 20 get concatenated to the string. The number is 20. Okay. Now we'll see about character data type. A is a variable, and if we assign R programs as a string to A, we can use the symbol A R program. Okay, A equal to R program. If we want to print value of A with the print command, it will show our program as we assign that character data type our program to that A. If we want to check the data type of object A, now A is a variable or it is also called as a object. So we can in R we can use class function. If we want to check the data type of particular class, a particular object or particular variable, we can use the class function. So after executing class function, it shows character data type. Then next thing we can check, if we want to assign character value and concatenate it on a variable, we can use fname. We can assign the variable fname as value Joe, then lname as Smith, and the value of both the variables as a paste, fname and lname. So Joe and Smith get replaced with fname and lname. And if we want to store this Joe Smith, value of fname and value of lname, with another variable, we can write the command paste fname comma lname equal to name. If we print value of name, it will show us Joe Smith. See here, Joe Smith will get display after executing name that statement or value of that name variable. Then cat, same use of cat as my name is and value of name is Joe Smith. So my name is Joe Smith. If we want to print it value of name, in that way also we can display the value of name as a Joe Smith. If we want to get the value of particular data type, we can use sprintf function. So we have written sprintf function as sprintf double quotes percentage s has percentage d dollars. So percentage s is Sam, percentage d is 100. So with this, Sam has $100. Then if we want to find substring of given string, we can use the function substring, substr function in R. So this substring function we have written in double quotes, Mary has a little lamb, and we want a substring from which start at 3 and stop at 13. So after executing it, it will print the substring from third character up to 13th. So after that, executing this function, we are getting output as ry has a li, means starting from 3, means r, starting from r, and 13th is nothing but li till here. Okay, and substitute. Now if we want to substitute the word in the existing string, sub function is there. In sub function, we are writing in the first double quotes the words which we want to substitute, and this is the string in which we want to substitute. So may sub little big and has a sentence is Mary has a little lamb. So after executing this, Mary, instead of little, we are substituting big. Okay, so this is the word little. Instead of little, we want big to substitute, and in the sentence this one. So our final answer or final string becomes Mary has a big, because we are substituting big instead of little. So thank you for watching this video.